In this part of the presentation, I'm going to show you how you can facilitate some group activities in your synchronous online instruction using Zoom's breakout rooms. I like to pair Zoom's breakout rooms with the Google suite of tools. I generally use Google Slides or Google Docs to send links to my students so they can work collaboratively from those breakout rooms. Yes, there is a whiteboard in Zoom, but I tend to not use that whiteboard as often because there's limited kinds of interactions that you can do on there, and it doesn't work as smoothly as a Google Doc, and it doesn't save as well. So I'm going to show you some of the different activities I've done in my class and how I facilitate that. Sometimes I use just a plain old Google Doc for those activities where I will create some templates or put some different activities on there. I decide how many groups I want in advance. So here's an example where I have 6 groups set up, and I usually just share a link to this document with the students in the chat of Zoom. And I make sure everyone's in before I put them in their breakout rooms, because that chat doesn't work from the main room to the individual rooms. You have to send them that link, make sure they can all get on there while you're explaining the directions, and then I push them into those breakout rooms. So to make sure you have the right kind of link, you push share and make sure you get the kind of link. You might have to change it so that anyone on the internet with the link can edit it. You don't want it view only, or the students won't be able to participate. I like to use this version of it because then the students don't need Google accounts if they don't have one. I also don't like to put student information on tools that aren't ISU tools. So if the students do put their name on it because I want to see that they were there, I just have them use their first name and last initial or some kind of nickname. But usually these activities are not graded, they're just for class participation. So I can copy that link, send it in the chat, and as a backup plan, I also post it to ReggieNet. So now here's this activity that I have here, and I've used some simple hyperlinks and bookmarks to make it easy for students to navigate. I'll show you what the activity looks like. There's 2 parts to this activity. I create the activity for the first group first. This is for a math methods course, so we're practicing doing some number talks and having conversations around mathematical patterns. So I've given them a picture, and then I have some prompts here, like a worksheet. So what patterns do you see? How many more steps in the sequence would it take them? So predicting the pattern and creating their own pattern. Then I've got the next set of directions. They can go to the next activity, which is one where they have to explain why one of these pictures doesn't belong with the other pictures. Again, the purpose of these activities for my class is so they have some mathematical discourse and they talk through some patterns to see what they notice. Once I've made group 1's activity, I just copy and paste and make a whole bunch of copies of them. I have a group 2, same things multiple times, group 3. But instead of having the students have to scroll through this document, I add these little bookmarks. If you want to add a bookmark, let's say I want to add one right here, all you do is click on Insert, Bookmark, and it'll put a bookmark right there. I'm going to undo that though, because I already had a bookmark on this row. When you're ready to hyperlink to them, what I've done is I've put each group here on a bullet point, and when they click on them, let's say it's group 4, they click on it, and it'll hop to group 4's bookmark over there. To do that hyperlink, if you've not done it before, let's say I want to hyperlink this, the word hyperlink here, I highlight it, I go to Insert Link, and in Google Docs, I can choose a specific bookmark that I've already added. So I go ahead and add those bookmarks first, and then I hyperlink to them here. The nice thing about this is when the students are in those breakout rooms, that I can monitor them while they're working from afar. This actually mirrors a lot of what I do in the classroom. So I can pull this document up. I'm not in the breakout rooms with them, but I can scan through their work. I can see what they're typing. And if I want to leave them a comment, I can highlight something they did and use the comments feature here to leave them a comment or to redirect them. If I see they're kind of going astray, they're going a little too far from what I want them to be doing, or they don't understand something, then I just pop into those breakout rooms, or they can call me into the breakout rooms. So I can still monitor the same kinds of activities that we were doing in the face-to-face classroom. We just do it on digital documents instead. Now, sometimes I use documents, and sometimes when they're like a larger project, I will do them with Google Slides. It's also an option. So this is an example of a problem-based learning lesson we were doing. And I gave them a scenario they had to talk through, and they were actually planning a lesson around this scenario. So they were working in groups to do a small group mini lesson planning activity. This time, instead of using the document, I just used slides for them to fill in. So you can see here, I basically made online graphic organizers for them to take their notes, and all the directions were in there for them. So everyone had the main task. This is group one got their own set of slides, and then I just duplicated this one for each group. So unlike the document, this is an example where I had to make copies of the original worksheets or digital task that I have for them. So I can just do file, make a copy, and then I can make one for each group. You can see this is labeled group one, section one, and then I can just keep renaming them. But what's nice about this is I have some breaking points. I knew that we were going to do a little bit of work in breakout rooms. I'd bring them back together. Then we'd go back into breakout rooms and I'd bring them back together. So I have some visual cues here for them to, you know, I wanted them to work on part one, stop, wait for me to call them back. Then we'd work on part two, stop, I'd call them back. So using slides is a great way. I can monitor everything they're doing, either Google Slides or Google Docs is a nice way to provide some collaborative activities that pairs really well with those breakout rooms.